Okay, dear students, I'm coming in front of you to explain the model of an atom. So many models have been given. The very first model which was accepted universally, that was the Thomson model of an atom. Thomson model of an atom, you can understand like this. You have seen the watermelon, cut it. So you will see a lot of seeds embedded into it. And the mass is there. All those the mass is considered as a positive and the seeds are considered as negative. So the mass is distributed entirely throughout the watermelon uniformly, as well as seed is also seed. Seed is embedded universally into the watermelon. So seed as well as mass which you eat in the watermelon, red color mass which you eat in the watermelon, that is universally distributed. It is distributed throughout the watermelon in a same manner. So distribution is uniform throughout the watermelon, that red part mass, red mass that is. And in that red mass, what is there? Lot of seeds are there. These seeds are also uniformly distributed in that red mass. Now in this watermelon, consider this seed as a negative charge, that is electron. Seed you consider as a electron, and the red mass which we consider it as a positive charge. Red mass in the watermelon, you consider it a positive charge. So that is uniform distributed, and the seed is considered as negatively charged electron, that is also uniformly distributed inside that watermelon. And this, in this watermelon, these seeds are embedded into it. So same model is taken. So consider atom as a watermelon. Consider atom as a watermelon, and the watermelon red mass is represents the positive charge, where the seeds representing the negative charge. So when you consider this, so there is a uniform distribution of charge throughout the watermelon. So there is a uniform distribution of charge entire atom, as well as mass is also distributed throughout the watermelon. Mass is also distributed uniformly throughout the atom. Charge is also distributed throughout the watermelon. Charge, that red part, is distributed throughout the watermelon universally. That means positive charge is universally distributed throughout the atom, and that red mass only gives the weight to that watermelon. So in this way, this positive charge are universally distributed throughout the atom, and that's why we consider that mass and charge is uniformly distributed. Uniformly distributed throughout the volume. That means the space occupied by the watermelon. So now the negative charge, which you consider it as a seed. Seed is also uniformly distributed throughout the red part, embedded into it uniformly. So that's why the mass as well as charge distributed throughout the volume uniformly. This is the basic concept of Thomson model. So in this model, what is happening? Positive charge and negative charge are staying together. Positive charge and negative charge are staying together next to next as the neighbors. So when this negative and positive charge touches one another, there will be destruction. But no atom got destroyed in this universe. All that means negative and positive charge will never touch with one another. So this is the drawback of the Thomson model. But here the number of positive charge and number of negative charge is same. So that's why it explains the neutrality of atom. By naturally atoms are neutral. It is only possible when the number of positive and number of negative charges are same. So the neutrality of the atom is explained. Neutrality of the atom are explained by Thomson model of an atom, which is also known as watermelon model. But it is unable to explain the stability of the atom, because in this model, positive charge and negative charge are staying together. So when they stay together, there will be destruction, they will touch, and there will be, it will get converted into energy. So, but there is no destruction at all in this universe. No atom got destroyed till today. That means there is a drawback. This stability of the atom could not be explained by Thomson. Second thing, that after the Thomson, Rutherford could have carried out a experiment, alpha ray scattering, on alpha ray experiment over the gold foil. So whatever observation is made in the Rutherford, all those observations could not be explained by this Thomson model. So later on, this Thomson model was rejected. Nowadays, we don't consider this Thomson model as a model of an atom. So now I will study the next Rutherford's nuclear model of an atom. So this is the experimental setup. How does this nuclear model of an, how does the Rutherford have carried out its experiment? What he has taken? He has taken a circular fluorescent screen. This is the circular fluorescent. How it is made fluorescent? This inner part is coated with zinc sulfide. This inner part is coated with zinc sulfide. And zinc sulfide is nothing but it's a fluorescent material. It is a circular curtain. It is a circular curtain, and the interior part of this circular curtain is coated with zinc sulfide. And zinc sulfide gets low when energy falls over it. That is where this zinc sulfide are taken. That means zinc sulfide gives us the fluorescent effect. And this is the gold foil. This is the gold foil we have taken. Gold foil, very very thin sheet of gold. The thickness of the gold foil is around 100 nanometer or 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. The thickness of gold foil is almost 100 nanometer or 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. This is the alpha rays, this is the beam of alpha rays. This beam of alpha rays is carried out by this lead plate. This lead plate has got a hole, and through which when this alpha rays passes through it, so it creates a beam of light, beam of alpha rays, which falls over this, which bombards this gold foil, and then we get a lot of glow. And this is the source of alpha rays. This is the source of alpha rays. How to get alpha rays? From any radioactive substance. For example, we have taken the uranium. This uranium is kept in a lead block. This is a lead block. In this lead block, here this uranium is kept. And uranium is a natural radioactive substance. It releases alpha, beta and gamma rays. We need here alpha rays only. And that's why it releases all the alpha, beta, gamma rays, and it comes out. And this lead process, in this lead, absorbs other rays, whereas alpha rays comes out of this sheet on this block and passes through this lead plate, that which is used as a slit system, and carry, and a narrow beam of alpha particle has been created by this, and this alpha particle bombards this gold foil. This gold foil has got bombarded with alpha rays. By this time, we know that alpha rays is what? It has got 2 positive charge and 4 unit mass. So we know we have got the awareness about by this. By the time this experiment was carried out, everything was known to the scientist regarding the alpha rays. So alpha rays having plus 2 charge and 4 unit of mass. So when this gold foil is striped or bombarded with this alpha rays, then we see, have seen that some of the glow is there. That means some of the rays passes through the gold foil and strikes, passes through in a straight line without any deviation, no deviation at all, and strikes at this position and gives you the glow at this position, fluorescence. It gets glowier. Some of the rays deviates with a small angle and strikes at this position and gives you the glow. Some of the rays deviates with a small angle at this position and gives you the glow. Some of the rays get deflected with a large angle, get deflected with a large angle and gives you glow here. Deflected with a large angle and gives you the glow here. So we have seen that when alpha rays passes through the gold foil, that means when the gold foil is bombarded with the alpha rays, it gives glow at different position. Okay, most of the glow are at in a straight line. Very few rays are deflected with a small angle, and even the slightest number of rays get deflected with a large angle. So these are the observation of the Rutherford model of an atom. So this is the entire setup of the Rutherford nuclear experiment. This is the alpha rays scattering experiment over the gold foil. So this is the setup. Now I'll explain how on the atomic basis. See that we consider that everything is made up of. We consider everything is made up of atom. So atom get arranged with one another one by one, like a bricks are arranged with one another while bringing up a wall. In case of wall, what we arrange? Bricks are arranged with one another. In the same way, atoms are arranged with one another adjacently. So see that this is the center part, this one atom, two atom, third atom, one, two, three. In this, so this part here, this is the atom, 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 this is the atom. So these are the atoms arranged, stacked with one another. These are the atoms got stuck with one another, arranged with one another in this way. And it is arranged in such a way that it should occupy the maximum space available to it. That means it should have the maximum possible density. So atoms should be arranged in such a way that it should have the maximum packing efficiency or maximum density. So now here it is arranged, it is packed together. Now see the atoms here. Now this ray you can see passes through straight line. Now you can see passes in a straight line. So most of the alpha particle passes through it without any deviation. This is a gold foil. So most of the alpha particle passes through the gold atom without any deviation. Okay, few number of alpha particle which is around the central part. Very few number of the alpha particle which is around the central part of atom got deflected with a small angle. This ray, you see that it is around the at the near the central part, get deflected from that point with a small angle. Okay, so few number of alpha particles get deflected with a small angle when it is near central part. So, but when now the third condition, some of the alpha rays get collision with the central part head to head collision. When the alpha rays get head to head collision with the central part, then see this alpha rays get collision head to head with the central part and get deflected with a large angle. You can see get deflected with a large angle. Here you can see this alpha rays get a head-to-head collision with this alpha particle, this central part, and get a large deviation. You can see this
alpha particle get the large deflection. Why? Because it has got head-to-head collision with the central part and it gets a large deflection. Okay, now the third condition is also there. Some of the alpha particles, when collide exactly 100% head-on collision, then it retraces its own path. That means it reflected on the same path, the path which it came. Like this alpha rays came and get collision with this head-to-head, 100% head-to-head, and up, and then reflected back on the same path. This is called it retraces its path. So these are the three phenomena we are observing, that most of the alpha rays passes through the gold foil without any deviation, and few numbers of alpha particles get deflected away, and the very very few numbers of alpha particle get head-on collision, and either it reflected back on the same path or get a large deflection. So on the basis of this observation, we'll make some conclusion. So on the basis of this experiment, Rutherford observed. What he had observed? Around 99% of alpha particles pass through gold foil without any deviation. This was the 99% of alpha particles pass through the gold foil without any deviation. Second, what he observed, that some alpha particle deflected with a small angle. And third, what he observed, that one out of 2000 particles, either deflected by, very large angle, or actually reflected back along their path, that is retraces his parts. So he had, Rutherford had made these three observations. Okay, now I'll take the same thing can be explained by taking single atom. This is the single atom we have taken. There are so many atoms were stuck together and then we have made an observation. This is the single atom. With this single atom will be observing. See here, the alpha rays which is exactly getting head-to-head collision with this central part get deflected with a large angle. Now you can see the alpha rays which is near the central part get deflected away from the central part with a small angle. So the rays which are near the central part get deflected away with the small angle, but most of the rays passes through the atom without any deviation. These four are representing 1, 2, 3, 4 without any deflection. So by taking the single atom, it become very easy to understand that most of the alpha rays passes through the atom without any deflection, and very few got deflected away from the central part of the atom, and one out of 2000 rays retraces its own path or either deflected by a large angle. So very easy to understand with this single atom. Now on the basis of this observation, we'll make the explanation of this observation. Now we have observed what is observation. Now we'll explain what is the reason behind this observation. So first observation, what is that? That the most 99% of alpha particle passes through, 99% of alpha particle passes through this atom without any deviation. It is only possible if the empty space is available. Nothing is there. Since the 99% of alpha particle passes through the atom without any deviation, so we can say that 99% of the space is empty. That means most of the space within the atom is empty. Nothing is there. So in the atom, lot of space is empty. This is the first
It is only possible if the lot of space is empty, then only something can pass through it without deviation. So first observation was explained on the basis of that what he said, that most part of the atom are empty, nothing is there. Now second thing was that some of the alpha particle deflected with a small angle. Some of the alpha particle is deflected with a small angle. It is only possible. Now we know that, first of all we must know what is alpha particle. Alpha particle has got a positive charge, two unit positive charge, as well as it has got a considerable mass, 4 unit of atomic mass. 4 unit of atomic mass, alpha particle has got 4 unit of atomic mass and 2 positive charge. So it has got considerable mass as well as considerable charge. Considerable positive charge. See here, the alpha particle which is passing near by the central part deflected away. It is only possible if the central part is positively charged. Because we know that alpha particle is positively charged and it is getting deflected away. So it is only possible it will deflect away from the central part in only the condition where the central part is positively charged. So on this basis we say that central part is positively charged. And second thing, that it is heavy, it is getting deflected away. Alpha particle is getting deflected away and it has got considerable mass also. So only the heavy particles can deflect it away. It has got 2 positive charge only. It has no much charge, it has got only 2 positive charge over it. Second thing, it has got considerable mass. Which has got considerable mass? Alpha particle has got considerable mass of around 4 unit mass. And 4 unit mass can be deflected away and pushed away only in those conditions if the heavy particles are involved in it. So that is why we say that at the central part heaviness is there, heavy particle is there, heavy constituent is there. That is why this positively charged alpha particle having 4 unit of mass get deflected away from the central part. So on this basis say that the central part of the atoms are heavy. Central part of the atom are heavy, and this central part which is heavy and positively charged have been given a name, nucleus, by Mr. Rutherford. So Rutherford has named this central part as nucleus. Okay, now last observation, what is there? The alpha particle which makes head-on collision, the alpha particle, what is the third observation? 1 out of 2000 particles either deflected by very large angle or actually reflected back along their path. So this observation we have to explain. It is only possible, it is deflected by large angle. It is only possible if the central part is, central space is occupied by positive center. Occupied by, the space is occupied by a positive center and the things are heavily situated over it. So, and alpha, this number of such alpha particle, the number of such alpha particle which are getting deflected away, the number of such alpha particle which are getting deflected away with the large angle, or it retraces its parts, such type of alpha particles are very very rare, very very rare. That means central part is very very small in size. Central part is very very small in size, because very few particles, 1 out of 2000 particles get collision head to head, get collision head to head. It is, that means the central part is very very small. That is why 1 out of 2000 particles get head to head collision with the central part. So on this basis we can say that the central part is very very small. Central part is very very small in size. That means the central part occupies very, very small space within the atom. So, these are the things which have been explained. And you can easily understand, you consider the cricket ball as a nucleus, kept at the central part of the playground. And the boundary considered as a periphery of the atom. Size of the atom is entire stadium. Size of the atom is entire stadium. And when you, this cricket ball is kept at the playing, the pitch over which we play, at the central part of the ground, then this central part of the ground where we keep the cricket ball, so that cricket ball represent the nucleus. Whereas the boundary of this cricket playing ground represents the size of that. So between the cricket ball and the boundary, lot of space is there. This entire space between the cricket ball and the boundary, that is the empty space through which the everything passes through, and very few will collide with the central part. So this I am explaining the Rutherford model. So we have explained the Rutherford observation, as well as we have explained the observation made by Rutherford. In the next lecture I'll explain the what is the Rutherford model actually over this experiment. Okay, thank you. I'll meet you all.